It's time for the Michael Walker Live!
So hello guys, it's me, Michael Walker, and today we are talking about the Sky News today, and also so yes, it's going to be a little bit of tennis and a little bit of news. So here's your Sky News right now.
Get that to get off air this summer. We're never beaten on price on fitted bike racks, so you can explore more.
So they're just doing the weather right now. So it looks like it's going to be hot for this week. Looks like. London is 21, that's not too bad. 21 guys. Part of Spain is 32. Either today or next week. So go and check out the YouTube channel, Sky News. And it's live every single time. It's a QR code. I'll try to get the QR code. And you can see the news and what is going on in the world. Yeah.
Hello, welcome back. If you're expecting Ian King live, we are continuing to follow the developing and breaking news regarding the BBC. So Ian King's programme is on our digital platforms. You can find panel there on your screen. You scan that QR code. You can find Ian. Sorry for any calls about that. But we're going to stick with this BBC story because it's developed over the last half an hour or so. There's a fresh set of allegations facing the unnamed male BBC presenter, and they come from a second young person totally unconnected to the allegations that surfaced last week. This is what we know at this point in the afternoon. The BBC presenter sent threatening messages to a young person in their early 20s. According to the BBC, the presenter met the young person first on a dating app before their conversations moved to other platforms. Presenter involved then revealed his identity and asked the young person not to tell anyone. The young person later posted online alluding to having had contact with an innocent presenter, hinted that they might name him. The presenter involved then allegedly sent the young person a number of threatening messages, which the BBC says it has seen and confirmed come from a phone number belonging to the presenter. The young person involved said they felt threatened by these messages and they remain scared. The news says it has contacted the presenter involved directly. They have also contacted his lawyer, but they have received no response to the allegation. Well, BBC Director General Tim Daly gave his first and only interview about this matter to the Radio 4's programme earlier on today. He was asked if he knew about any more allegations. Here's what he said.
And have there been any other allegations or complaints made against the same presenter?
Because this is a subject of active police discussion in terms of benefit or they want to be moving forward. Absolutely, I cannot comment on that.
Okay, let's speak now to media law consultant David Banks. David, thank you very much for jumping on to speak to us about this breaking news. What do you make about this new set of allegations? How does this feed into the overall picture?
Well, as this was happening, as your colleagues called me, I was literally writing a piece for the Indie, and I was typing the words, "There are more twists to this story."
Oh,
and then we get this happening. I think it does change things quite considerably. We saw happen the weekend, we saw the kind of social media mob attacking the BBC. Then, when we got the statement yesterday from the young person at the centre of it, a subsection of the mob has.
Okay, guys. Don't worry about your favourite ad. So, let's have Dorchester Green Green Grass.
Amazon Prime Day is here. 2 days of epic deals that'll make you feel big deal. Deals on electronics, home, kitchen, and more. Amazon Prime Day is the 11th and 12th of July, exclusively for Prime members. Shop now.
She comes to me, and she turns out all the lights and says she's coming for me. And I put your hands up, this is a heist, and there's no one in here living girl to make it out alive. And the song comes down, get away, caught between your lovers. Miracles straight out of town, over the hills, and undercover, undercover, undercover. Green, green grass, blue, blue sky. You dance to a party on the day that I die. Green, green grass, blue, blue sky. You dance to a party on the day that I die. All together, and I'm an evil. And the girl is so much more than just another apple. She lives, works, and learns.
So that was just green, green grass, blue, blue sky. Well, green, green grass. So here's a little bit of tennis.
welcome to Carlos Alcaraz's press conference. A reminder to raise your hand if you'd like to ask a question. I'll start. Carlos, how are you feeling after that match today?
I'm really happy but excited at the same time.
So if no, so the tennis, I think there's some competition is going on today. So you heard a little bit of the tennis people, and here's a little bit of Harry Kane.
He desperately wants to know if they're going to be with or without Kane, so yeah. he can build without him or with him around him. If he's playing, you'll have certain dynamics and relationships around Kane that will differ if he goes and you have to bring in a striker. So he needs to know that.
Okay, so we're going to have a little bit of another song and we are going to be sadly say goodbye. So here's Save Your Tears.
Getting that from YouTube.
Here's a Save Your Tears. They were saying goodbye. We're going to play Half of It, guys, and I'll see you soon. Yeah. Bye bye.
So happy when I'm done with you. The new song, we got you passing by. Oh, you don't want it from your eyes. I don't know why. I don't know why. I don't know why. I don't know why. You could have asked me why.
Too late.